more three-way mania coming at you here, IPW fans. Here you see challenger number one for the very, very competitive TV title. It's Uptown Frankie Gabon,
the leader of the Double Deuce, wearing one of the most ridiculous pairs of sunglasses I have ever seen. Take this guy seriously. Don't pay attention to how he's dressed. Don't matter who he's in the ring with, but he's got his hands full tonight. There's the madman himself, the master of the claw hold, Jet Jaguar.
Jet Jaguar coming out without chump change Ron Neamey. Frankie Capone coming out without his manager, the manager of champions, Mike Gold. But here you see the man who's the champion, my friend, and look at that, Rod Steele.
Rod Steele, your IPW television champion, the man that you claim to be good friends with. He's got nothing good whatsoever to say about you, and he doesn't care about you. What he cares about is defending that title against Jet Jaguar.
Oh,
wow, hands up the mic and basically kicks his face right across the ring.
Frankie Capone shot off the ropes by Rod Steele, but he misses with a clothesline, then a reverse clothesline. And look at Frankie Capone. He's going at it tooth and nail with your champion. He came in here with one purpose and one purpose only, to prove he belongs to Rod Steele and become your new television champion. But Rod Steele tackles him and takes over. And here comes Jet Jaguar back out with a big uppercut to Rod Steele. These two guys absolutely hate each other.
You can sense the urgency in all three men, and they're doing everything they can to capitalize on the offense of the men they're in the ring with. Who's going to come on this as the champion? I don't know. Jet Jaguar, known for his European uppercuts, known for the hard punch, known for the claws. He's known for everything in this business except for having any couth, any manners, or anything whatsoever that resembles being a gentleman.
Here comes Jet Jaguar up in the top rope, dies off on both individuals. One thing that nobody talked about in this match, all three men, former IPW light heavyweight champions, Jet Jaguar on multiple occasions. Rod Steele will tell you he was the last IPW light heavyweight champion before it became the Florida Unified Cruiserweight title. And these guys, they're not even in the ring. They're taking it all over the place. Rod Steele grabbing a chair. I don't even know what to say anymore, Ron Neamey.
Rod Steele is basically the man that wants to portray being out of control. He wants to look like there's no semblance of order. He knows exactly what's going on, and what he's doing is braining Jet Jaguar with a chair before getting a receipt of his own. Frankie Capone, once again, he's thinking. He stands back in the shadows and watches Jet Jaguar get the life knocked out of him, and he takes that opportunity and he levels him. Look at the fans. They're right there. They're right in the middle of the action. If they don't watch out, they might get a chair upside their head.
So with these guys, not only are they going for the IPW television title, not only are they trying to prove that these men that they absolutely can't stand are not worthy of being in the ring. Well, claw-home by Jet Jaguar. This could be it.
That could be it, but he's on the outside of the ring. He won't be the champion. You're not going to get it outside of the ring. Get in the ring, Jet Jaguar. Tomorrow night, Lealman Discovery School, right across the street from the WrestlePlex on 35th Street in St. Petersburg. I don't know who your IPW television champion will be, but you can rest assured that title will be defended. And Frankie Capone and Jet Jaguar, these guys seem to be digging really deep. Rod Steele's got his work cut out for him tonight if he's going to go into Lealman as your champion.
Just a few seconds ago, you saw Frankie Capone taking a page out of my buddy Vito DiNucci's book, using the chair super kick combination to take out your champion, Rod Steele. As I was going to say before, not only are these guys going for it for personal reasons and for title glory, they know they just saw a hell of a three-way dance on our opener, and they're doing everything they can to prove they can not only match it, but top it.
Gentleman Jim Bragg doing what I like to see, referee using his head. He knows the importance of the IPW television title. He's taking the rule book and basically threw it out the window. There is no count out. He's going to give him a hell of a lot of leeway as far as the disqualification rule. We want to see a champion. The fans of IPW demand it. There ain't going to be no count outs. There ain't going to be no disqualifications. The 87-year-old Jim Bragg is going to make sure that we have a winner.
That's why they left you and Mike Gold at home. They not only want to all look, he's putting on the glasses of Frankie Capone. And I didn't think Jet Jaguar could look any sillier, but I was wrong. Oh, and Rod Steele comes in. He puts Jet Jaguar on his shoulders, holding for Frankie Capone. Oh, big miss as Jet Jaguar rolls through. One, two, oh, I thought Jet Jaguar was going to add another title to his previous great, great resume.
Jet Jaguar taking opportunity when it knocks. Who the hell would have thought he'd come with a victory roll out of basically getting hit with the doomsday device, but Frankie Capone missed by 16 yards, diving across with a cross body block was about as pathetic as one I've seen Tommy Rich try to execute in 1992 against Buddy Roberts.
You saw that?
No, I didn't. I just read about it. Oh, my God. A huge powerbomb and suplex combination. Everybody's leveled. Come on, Jim Bragg. You got to count faster than that. I don't even like Frankie Capone. Why Why am I saying to come faster than that? I meant slower. For God's sake, give the Jaguar time to recuperate.
You can't even decide what you want. Jed Jaguar is one of your own guys. He's been loyal to you all the way, except when you stabbed him in the back a couple years ago that you conveniently gloss over anytime you get the chance. Frankie Capone, the uncrowned television champion, as far as I'm concerned.
With the spinning sidewalk slam on Jed Jaguar, he's not the uncrowned champion. Frankie Capone should count his blessings. If it wasn't for the huge credentials he amassed on his tour of Puerto Rico, where the internet, look at that, it looks like a fisherman's reverse neck breaker.
Mr. 498 laying on the canvas, two, oh, almost a three count. Rod Steele, that's who's going to win this match, I guarantee it.
You've picked three different individuals so far, and you've guaranteed every time. What the hell kind of neck breaker is that? I think that actually broke his back. That's a vicious neck breaker.
That was the Jumpin' Jet Jam.
The Jumpin' Jet Jam absolutely levels Rod Steele, who's in the corner over there. Dead to the world. Frankie Capone comes over, hits him with some wicked move. Jim Bragg's blown up. I got no oxygen left. Aaron, take over.
Frankie Capone has tried pending combinations on both individuals on several occasions. He's the man that knows. He may not be able to go cardiovascular-wise with these guys. He wants to get this match over with, but both of these gentlemen kicking out, and gentlemen is a term I use very, very loosely. Oh, and it looks like the claw hold coming back for Jed Jaguar.
Jed Jaguar hit the Irish hammer that you conveniently ignored, setting up this claw hold, which is easily, it's going to be your new IPW television champion. Double claw hold! Oh my God, the double claw hold. Jed Jaguar is going to have both men submit. It's going to be a double submission, Jaguar style. Double nut shot. Forget everything I just said.
Yes, as we usually do. And Frankie Capone, faking like he's playing along with Rod Steele, goes, what, neck break. One, two, three. I told you he'd be the new television champion.
You told me everyone was going to be. Anyway, your new IPW television champion, Uptown Frankie Capone, the leader of the Double Dukes, his biggest victory to date in IPW. Frankie Capone, your new champion.